special concert. I want to, my name is Amos Wright. I'm the music coordinator for the Rock Canyon Ward, and I'm very happy to have arranged this wonderful, wonderful evening for you. I know you'll enjoy it. I want to say special thanks to a few people, the stake presidency and the bishops who have, of our stake and of this ward and this building, who have supported this idea very, very generously and happily. So I'm happy for them. I want also to recognize Brother Lauren Anderson, who has done the technology, which gives you an opportunity to see the organ on the big screen. And Brother Welch told me once, he said, a lot of people don't even know that you use your feet to play the organ. And so you can see his feet moving on this screen. Wonderful. Our performing artist is Brother James Welch, and he has generously offered to play this concert. I met him about 3 or 4 months ago when he played a funeral here for Brother Bob Daines, who passed away. And I was so impressed with the organ playing that I went up and made myself acquainted. And right then and there, he said, if you'd like me to play a concert for this group, I'd be happy to do so. Now he's fulfilled that promise. Wonderful. You can read more about Brother Welch's background in the program. There's quite a nice paragraph about him there. The organ itself is much improved over what it was to begin with. This organ was installed in 1974 when the building was first built, and it was a very minimum pipe organ. If you count the pipes, there's just 12 of the main regular pipes and 12 wooden ones. You have to have at least that many to have a pipe organ. So it was just a minimum pipe organ at the time, because people had to pay for it out of their own pockets. This wasn't a shared affair by the church. But most recently, the organ has been modified and augmented. Brother Welch says it's one of the nicest organs in the whole valley now, so you're getting a chance to hear it as it is augmented. It was augmented by the Anderson Organ Company in Cache Valley during the time of COVID, and they did an excellent, excellent job. So we are going to proceed with the program. The numbers are listed on your program. Applause is appropriate. If you feel like you appreciate the number, Jim would appreciate some applause, I'm sure. Brother Welch will probably make a comment or two as we go along, explaining some of the pieces to you. We will not have a closing prayer, but we will have an opening prayer. Brother Adam Dyer of the Rock Canyon Ward Bishopric has graciously agreed to give an opening prayer, and then we'll turn the time over to Brother James Welch.
Our loving Father in heaven, we are so grateful for the ability to gather to celebrate this music that Brother Welch has prepared. We invite the Spirit to be with him, to strengthen him, and allow him to share the music that he has prepared in the very best ways possible. And we pray that we would soften our hearts and receive thy Spirit, that we might have our minds and hearts and spirits touched by gathering together tonight. We are especially grateful for our neighbors and friends to gather as a stake and to share uplifting recreation together. And we love thee, Father. There are so many blessings that we can never enumerate all of them, but we love thee and we honor thee with this concert, and we say this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you so much for being here this evening. It's a great pleasure to be here, to see all of you and to play this wonderful organ and meet some friends, people that I already know, and make some new friends. My wife and I moved here about a year ago and are delighted to be here in this community. Everywhere we go, we run into people that we've known in different ways. I want to start by thanking Brother Wright, Amos Wright. I've learned if you want to get something done, he makes it happen. I just threw out that little comment about playing a concert. Next thing you know, well, here we are. And I said, well, do you suppose there's somebody who has a camera and they could put a camera together and we could have a video so people could see? Sure enough, he comes up with Lauren Anderson, who has done a marvelous job with the sound system tonight in the live stream. And then just as Brother Dyer was coming up and we said hello, he sort of looked at each other and realized that we had shared a ride, a chairlift ride at Sundance a few weeks ago. But he had on a helmet and a mask, and I had on a helmet and a mask, and we had a great conversation. It was the first time I'd ever seen him in person. But everywhere we go, we have great experiences like this. Well, the program tonight, the goal is to play something for everybody, to show off all the things that this organ can do. Well, maybe not all, but quite a few things that it can do. Things from different periods of music. I'll give a little demonstration as I go along. But I'm going to open with a piece by an American composer. It's called Prelude in Classic Style, a fun little thing. And then the most famous organ piece ever written, the Toccata and Fugue in D minor. This was a request of Brother Mo's Wright. He said, I don't care what you play, but you play that. So you're going to get the Toccata and Fugue in D minor. It's an interesting piece. Nobody's really quite sure who wrote it. It's attributed to Bach, but there's no proof that he wrote it. Certainly from his time period, but we'll give him credit for it. And after that, a little piece by a Portuguese composer from the time of Mozart, João de Sousa Carvalho, a piece that was written. The organs in Portugal, as opposed to in northern Germany, the Portuguese organs didn't have foot pedals. So Bach really took advantage of the pedals. The Portuguese and the Spanish, they never did learn how to play the pedals. Thank you. Dale Wood is one of my favorite composers for organ. If you listen to the music and spoken word, about every other week, I'm not kidding, one of the tabernacle organists will play one of his pieces. He wrote about 140 hymn arrangements and folk tune arrangements. He was a California composer, and he wrote this piece as on a commission for the anniversary of an organ in Kansas. And since it was a birthday sort of thing, he wrote in "Happy Birthday to You" in a few places, and you will hear it. It's subtle, but it's there. Then Jerusalem, a wonderful British anthem, which you probably heard in Chariots of Fire. In fact, the poem by Blake that this is the music was written to includes that line, "Bring me my chariot of fire." And I'm playing that because my wife and I, Deanne, will you stand up so people will know who you are? Yes. We'll be leaving. Well, we would have been to Jerusalem and back by now, but thanks to COVID, we're still waiting. But we think that we're leaving next month, and we hope that that works, and we'll be there probably 18 months, where I'll get to play that wonderful organ in the Jerusalem Center Auditorium. Now, after that, I have an opera piece. Now, Puccini didn't write anything for the organ. It's too bad, but he wrote such beautiful music. But this Nessun Dorma is one of the most beautiful tunes ever written, and I thought, well, it deserves to be played on the organ, so I made my own arrangement of it. And then we have Rick Elliott's arrangement of the Ode to Joy from Beethoven's Ninth Symphony. Now, you know, Rick Elliott is a convert to the church and started out his career playing in rock bands, and very versatile and probably can play theater organ as well. Most good organists are really closet theater organists, and I think he's one of those as well. And you'll notice at the very end of that piece, there's a pedal glissando all the way to the bottom of the keyboard and a sort of a Saturday night chord instead of a Sunday morning chord. And then we've got I'll return to the microphone at that point. So if you have watched Rick Elliott play on the Christmas specials and all, that's just one of his tricks, but he's a great organist. This next one, Chinese Boy and Bamboo Flute, it was written in 1938 by an American who went to China as a Christian missionary, and he heard a young boy playing a traditional melody on the flute. And when he got home, he wrote this arrangement. So this is an actual Chinese traditional tune about the water lily. Then we have Battle Hymn of the Republic. Rex Corey was a Hollywood organist, and he wrote the theme for Gunsmoke, among other things, just in case you were wondering. And I've got three American hymn arrangements, these Amazing Grace and Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing. Will they show up in our new hymnal? We'll see. The Amazing Grace was written by Christopher Pardini, who was then the organist of the Crystal Cathedral in Orange County, also known to organists, the Crystal Cathedral known as the Silica Basilica. Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, what a wonderful American tune that is. And then Dan Miller's arrangement of Count Your Blessings. What did I say about a theater organist?
Thank you.
a perfect piece for special music, don't you think, in sacrament meeting? Maybe not. Now, since you liked that eye roller piece so much, I'm going to throw in an extra little goodie for you now. This is a piece written by Porter Heaps, who made the Hammond organ sort of famous in the 40s and the 50s. It's called The Nocturne for the Orange. Following that, the Ashokan Farewell, and you will recognize this, it sounds like an old Civil War fiddle tune. It was written for the Ken Burns series on the Civil War, but it was written for that. It's not an old American tune. And then to conclude, the famous toccata from Vidor's Symphony No. 5. Vidor was the organist at Saint-Sulpice, the largest church in Paris. He was the organist there for 60 years. And I had the privilege of playing that organ on one occasion. So again, thank you so much for being here. Now, Nocturne for the Orange, Ashokan Farewell, and the Toccata.
Thank you.
already played my encore for you, the orange piece. So thank you so much for coming. Thank you, Brother Wright, for helping put this together. Lauren Anderson, where are you? Are you hiding back there? Thank you for... I don't know how these guys do it, plugs and wires and so much stuff. He's got the equipment. I really appreciate his work on that. And thank you to this ward and stake, and for all of you for coming, and hope we'll see you again sometime. Thank you.